Now, let us learn about Shershah Suri. So, as we have learned previously about the Humayun, from 1513 to 1526, so in between you can see the gap, 1530 and 1540, 10 years. So, Humayun was imprisoned by Shershah Suri and Shershah Suri started to rule Mughal dynasty only for a short period, 5 years. CE means common era. So, who is this Shershah Suri? Do he belong to the Mughals? No, he was not having any blood relation to Mughal dynasty. As he came to the power, what was the original name of Shershah Suri? The Shershah Suri name, original name was called Farid. And he was the founder of the dynasty called Sur dynasty. Who was the founder of the Sur dynasty? Shershah Suri. Yes, Shershah Suri. Can you observe this picture, children? Yeah, children, observe this picture. Shershah Suri, the founder of the Sur dynasty, his original name was called Farid. So, as he was his childhood, he was lacking the parents' love. And later, for so many years, even he was a wanderer. And later, he was working under a king. The place of South Bihar was a king. The king was called Bahar Khan. So, when he was ruling under Bahar Khan, the South Bihar, he killed a tiger with single-handed. And so he earned a title called Sher Khan. The title was given by Bahar Khan. For whom? For Shershah Suri. That his original name was Farid. And Shershah Suri, he worked significantly. He worked hard. And way he defeated Humayun and conquered the places like Punjab, Sindh, Multan, Gwalior, Malwa. Many more places were annexed by Shershah Suri. And the whole north part of India was under Shershah Suri, just leaving India to the east part like Assam and also Gujarat, Kashmir. So he was not able to conquer. Now let us see about the administration of Shershah Suri. When he was ruling very for short period, he was a person to introduce two powers. One is called the civil and military powers. So in this, he was very strict. To manage this, the entire kingdom, he divided the regions called Sarkar and Paranganas. Paranganas means group of villages. And in that, he divided the two provinces on the military and civil. So here, he organized this group in three. One is called the cavalry, infantry and elephant divisions. He divided these three groups. Among them, the powerful group was called cavalry, and he wanted to bring his army in very good honesty, discipline. So what he did? He maintained attendance for the soldiers here. And after maintaining attendance for the soldiers, stamping, that is for the horses, it's called the dag of horses. And the army was divided into small units, that is called Fauz, and he appointed one as a commander, Fauzdar, to take an in charge and responsibility. Shershah Suri, he was personally interested in organizing the army. He himself used to organize the discipline of the army. And that's it. Next comes here about the land revenue. So it was a source income for kingdom, cultivable land. So the land was measured to the fixed amount where the people had to pay a tax. On what basis? That's called land taxes here. So he divided the land tax in three types, that is good, average and lower. So if the people are having a very good land, the farmers, they had to pay the tax here. Average, average and lower, that is to the natural disaster, if there's a floods and droughts, the people are not able, depends on them whether to pay or not. That is during the period of Shershah Suri here. The crops had to be paid on 1/3 of the harvested crop as land tax. So he said, you people are cultivating the crop here, so 1/3 of the harvested crop to be paid as a land tax a compulsory. And then here, the next comes here, justice. Yes, he was well known. So he has earned a title called the Lion King of India. The title earned by Shershah Suri. He is very well known for giving justice also. From very far places, the people used to come and seek an advice and justice from Shershah Suri. So he was known for his impartial justice. He used to give the equal justice for everyone. He never sees that they are rich, they are poor. The equal justice was given for each and everyone here. So here the title he earned for the justice known as Sultan of the Fair Justice, and he was having a high superiority, the highest judge in his kingdom, and he decided all the final appeals. In the sense, in emergency cases and all, Sheshah Suri used to solve the problem and he used to give the justice for. Yeah, Sheshah Suri was giving a very good judgment for the people, and he conducted only every Wednesday evening. The people used to come from very far places for the sake of equal justice in Sheshah Suri kingdom. And Sheshah Suri, he brought one more new organization in his dynasty, that's called silver coin. What was the silver coin title? It was known as Dam. And here in the circulation of these coin, how did they measure? It was a type of seeds. It's called licorice. Now it is very, it can be seen in foreign candies here. It's used. So 180 licorice, the seeds to be given to measure this. Coins here, which coin? That is silver coin. And this was continuous, this was practiced in Mughal dynasty, which was done by Sheshah Suri here. And he is a person to show the highway, as now we have the highway of NS 73, 105 and all. So this started during the period of Mughal dynasty by Sheshah Suri. That's called a Grand Trunk Highway. I'll show you the picture, children, here. Yeah, children, can you observe this picture? This is the military army of Sheshah Suri. He himself used to pay and visit for the soldiers, whether they are maintaining a good discipline, whether they are doing the work in good way or what. For each and everything, where he divided his kingdom under three. So the maintenance work of soldiers. Yeah, children, see, this is a plant. Licorice seeds, these are seeds. So this was a circulation during the period of Sheshah Suri, where the coins measured by the seeds, the silver coins called as Dam. Yes, children, can you see Sheshah Suri and the Grand Trunk Roads, that's called the highway. So he was the first person to invade the highways during his rule. The highway roads by Sheshah Suri can have a long march to the distance for the travelers. Even the trees were planted where the people, the travelers, if they are tired, they can have the shelter. And in between, 1700 sarayas where the people can take the shelters or resting, relaxation. Relaxation houses were built up for the travelers here. As now we have the lodges, hotels. So during that time, sarayas were built up by Sheshah Suri. That was constructed. And what are the main four? The four main highways from Sonargaon on the bank of River Indus through Agra, Delhi and Lahore. From Agra to Burhanpur. From Agra to Chittor, from Lahore to Multan. So these are the five highways that constructed by Sheshah Suri during his rule.